film products, and it's probably gonna look crappy, the footage, because I'm actually filming it on my iPhone 5, I believe is the one I have. I'm actually really excited because I'm very passionate about filmmaking, and I really want to invest in this product for a while, but it's really pricey. It's about $500 after taxes, and the product that we're going to get, it's called the triangular system. Basically what it is, it's three suction cups with these bars that make this triangle, where you can mount your DSLR camera on the outside of the car and get really interesting shots. And the main reason why I want to get it is because I usually rely on somebody to go filming with me, which is David. And sometimes, you know, in life, he has his own family, he has kids, stuff comes up, and I don't have anybody to help me shoot the rolling shots. So my theory is, if I hook up the suction cup on the outside of my Evo and hook up like an LCD right here, I can monitor it and drive as we're filming the rolling shots. So I'd be basically independent and wouldn't be needing anybody to help me do a Cars on Board episode for the documentary films that we do. And on top of that, I want to experiment to get different shots, because I want to make the production value of this channel really good. You know, my inspiration is Petrolicious. If you guys haven't subscribed to that, go subscribe to that, because those guys, they're the guys that influenced me the most to do what I do. The only problem with them that I had, the reason why I started the channel was because they did the exact same films that I do, but they only concentrate on like classic vintage cars that are very special. And I would always thought, like, dude, if they did something that like this, but with like cars that everybody has, like that the majority of people have, like Evos and Supras and all the cars that we have covered, that channel would kick ass. I have to turn on the AC, so I'm gonna try to talk a little louder. It's getting hot. It's what is it? We're in November and it's 79 degrees. California. We're in Burbank. So this place I'm going to, it's called Film Tools. They sell everything for filmmaking, anything that you need for filmmaking. Like, one thing that's specific that I buy there is tape. Yes, I said tape. There's film tape. It's called gaffer's tape. And this tape is special because it doesn't leave residue. Because when I record the audio on the cars, I have cables running on the cars, and I have to literally tape them down, or the tire's gonna eat them up, or they're gonna roll off, or whatever. So I buy this special gaffer's tape, which is not that expensive. I think it's like for a big roll like that. I've had one for 2 years, and I still haven't run out. It costs about like, I think like $10, and it's really tough and it's really easy to rip. It's like almost like a cloth. They sell that kind of stuff. Slates. Oh, STI. Nice. Super stanced out. So Film Tools. This place is located in Burbank, out here in California. A lot of the studios are out here in Burbank, post-production, which is what I do. That's my daytime job. I actually work for this company called and I'm not going to say where I work, actually. I'm going to edit that. I work at a post-production house out here in Burbank, California. I'm not gonna say the name of it, but it's out here. So we're here at Film Tools, and we're gonna buy the item. I'll show you, I'll shoot some B-roll. Hopefully, the reason I'm filming with the iPhone is because I wanna be low-key. I was gonna bring the GoPro, but I didn't know they'd probably catch me really quick. And everybody has a phone, so I'll run around so you guys get some footage and check out what I'm talking about. I probably won't talk because it'd be obvious. So let's go check it out. So right here, we're walking into Film Tools. Film Tools is basically like a Toys R Us, but for filmmakers. They got a bunch of tools, or let me say a Home Depot or a hardware store. But basically, you can buy anything that has to do with filmmaking. Camera equipment, rigs, chairs. You see those director chairs there? So these are the suction cups that are gonna come with the triangular system. I recorded this guerrilla style using my iPhone because I didn't want to get caught. Right here, what you're watching is the hardware for what I'm gonna buy. And at the end of the video, you guys will see what it is. And here's the movie tape that I was talking about. In the industry, it's called gaffer's tape. And this tape's pretty cool because I can use it to tape down the microphone cables on the cars, and it does not leave residue, even if the sun hits it, and it's easy to tear. Good stuff. And right here, we also got the lights, LED lights. Pretty cool because you can adjust the temperature on them. Those are some Mole Richardsons. Those have been around in the industry of filmmaking for years. And right here, what you guys are looking at are called C-stands. And these C-stands basically hold flags that block shade for your talent or your camera guy or whatever. Basically, they hold stuff. And these are called Apple boxes. And these are used for like a camera guy to sit on while he's filming. Or in a movie like Rocky, they used it to make I believe the Russian guy looked taller on camera. And these are just little clips. Check out this rig. So this is basically what I bought. It's a rigging system to rig stuff where it's not supposed to mount a camera. This thing gets crazy to rig the bicycle, all the different setups you could do. And basically the system is like Lincoln Logs that you could set it up. All right guys, so I was finally able to set up the triangular system that we purchased at Film Tools today. And I wanna give you guys a little shot so you guys can see what it's like. It's pretty sick. That's the first angle that I did. I don't know if you can see it too well, but it's a cool little angle. It's getting dark, but that's the setup. So basically, if you just have this item right here, I can't really see. I'm gonna switch the camera. As you guys can see, like this piece right here, if I just had that piece, it would be really flimsy. So by having three suction cups and connecting here at the top, it makes this triangle effect, which is, that's why it's called triangular system, and it's really steady. Like I'm shaking it, barely shakes. It's like really steady, so the only thing is that you're all Back to the Futured out. You gotta be careful that when you're driving, you don't hit any trees or any cars. Also, it probably wouldn't be a smart idea to like have this set up on the freeway because a cop will see you and probably ask if you have a permit. So we'll probably only use this in the canyons or like deserted roads. So you can see how big the setup is, pretty huge. But it does break down, we can make it smaller. We have this little riser pad right here. This thing actually comes down and you can connect that back to here. So it'd bring the camera to like this height, so it won't be as big. We're just messing around with it. But here's the cool angle. Just imagine like right here on this part up here, if they're like in the canyons and like big trees passing, it would give it a really nice cinematic look. Right now it looks very dead because it's a stationary shot, but you guys see in the future videos. It's pretty cool. I'm kind of excited. All right guys, well that's that. Talk to you later.
Nothing. Automatically I thought someone was playing with me. It wasn't until at least like 10 seconds I realized that my super got stolen.